Welcome inside Staples Center. It is X Games 16, and we have seen some dirt bike insanity already tonight. And of course, PLG just bringing home the gold, the skateboarding vert. But right now, we are going Moto X Best Trick. And Brian Deegan, who has joined us in the booth, simply calls it the most incredible competition of the year. So get ready to watch. And speaking of incredible, this is Kyle Loza, the man who invents what people think is impossible and puts it to dirt three-time. That's right, three-time X Games gold medalist consecutively. Unfortunately, due to an injury to his wrist, he will not be able to defend and go for the four-peat. And Kyle Loza, a Monster Energy athlete, and speaking of Monster Energy, they have been cool enough to deliver you this Moto X Best Trick in its entirety. So, we are going to be having little or no commercials through the rest of the X Games, thanks to Monster Energy Drink. Very cool. And first up will be the rider who got into the competition as an alternate because Kyle Loza decided not to run. If I'm not mistaken, Levi Sherwood.
Yeah, here he goes. It's what he called would be a safety trick, a dead body flip. He's riding smart tonight because he thinks that if a lot of guys try and fail, he could just get on the podium by landing a really cool trick. Do you think it's a good strategy, Brian?
Well, you come to Best Trick, you have to lay it down. Every time you get on that bike, Best Trick's only two tricks. You got to lay it down both times, so we'll see what happens.
Taking another look. Gets the legs straight through. Nice extension on the body. 75-foot ramp jump is what he's electing to use. There are a couple options out there, and wow. Tess, I mean, great execution.
Levi Sherwood has got great extension. The kid is so flexible. He's a really phenomenal rider and did incredibly well yesterday, of course, in the freestyle competition, taking silver. So, right. You know, he's a good rider.
We'll wait for the score. Of course, he's in first place from New Zealand at 84.33. And Brian Deegan, you can bring a little bit of expertise here for sure. 2003, you broke out the 360, brought home the gold medal. Talk about what this is, the groundbreaking, going huge, as one of your teammates from the militia, Taka Higashino from Japan, takes the course.
This is the event that really built freestyle motocross, is one up and the next guy laying down your biggest trick. So right now, we're going to see Taka lay it down. He's mastering the double grab back at the compound, so we'll see how it goes. But this is the event that means everything in freestyle.
Here we go, Taka. Many people claiming this is his breakout year.
Whoa! Nice. Oh, I can't wait to see the replay of that one. He gets great extension on it, too. Unbelievable.
Taka's always had great extension on his seat grabs. He just learned to take both hands off and grab the seat. Great extension, good heart attack.
Let's take another look at it. Tess, he gets back. And he doesn't walk his hands back. We've been seeing him walk his hands back. It looks like he went straight back to the grab.
That's amazing. I mean, let's see if he lets go at the same time with both hands. And look at that, poking out. Look how far he is off that bike, how far he is away from the bars. If those bars turned, he'd be in trouble.
Awesome double grab.
The Mega Mo, Brian, you were one of the first to do that right side up. Yeah. Now your riders, Taka, and of course the late Jeremy Lusk bringing that to prominence.
Solid.
Let's see what the judges think. I'm going to say it's probably going to do it. What do you think, Tess?
Well, that was a pretty big trick. It didn't break the 90 barrier yet, though, only 89.66. What's Todd going to deliver here tonight, Brian?
I think Todd is probably going to lay down another safety trick. We'll see. Todd, he's been working on his freestyle and best whip. We'll see. We'll probably see another kiss of death.
Well, here we go, Todd Potter.
Going for the cliffhanger flip, not getting all of it. Now, something you need to know about Potter is he was disappointed last year because he didn't have something new, but he was able to medal with it. He has medaled in 2007, 2008, and 2009. Last year with the cliffhanger flip.
So look at this. It's a pretty weak cliffhanger. Look, he's bent at the waist. I mean, this might have got him, you know, some glory last year, but it's not going to do it for him this year. He needs to pull something really big in that second run.
And the score coming in. That'll put him in third place.
No surprise.
No surprise, really, right? And, of course, we are going to be going through commercial free thanks to Monster Energy Drink through this best trick. And it's really cool that they did this because it gives the athletes just the ability to flow through. So it's something cool, very, very unique. And we're going to see that again in the skateboard best trick later. And here's a brand new rider. I mean, when you're brand new to this, it's got to be so unnerving. This is Rich Kearns, and I know he's got some huge tricks.
Yeah, I've heard a lot about this guy. This is a big stage.
And he gets through the bars as he's inverting. Now, ladies and gentlemen at home, if you weren't watching Freestyle, we explained that, yes, we will pick these jumps apart a little bit. We may sound mean. No, Tess and I cannot do these tricks. Brian Deegan can, but Brian, it just didn't look like he got, it looks like he hung up going through.
Hung up a little bit. It was kind of a weak bar hop and overjumped it a little bit. Maybe he's a little nervous for his time X Games. And he's riding a 450, which you have to hit the ramp at a different speed. It's easy to overjump on those.
You can see here in the Mega Mo shot that he really doesn't get extended. He's trying to do this as a dead body variation where you need to be lying parallel to the seat, right? And I mean, obviously, he's way away from that.
And in fourth place, so the judges not excited. Another first-time X Gamer coming up next. This is Clinton Moore, and he had a big welcome to X Games when he first jumped the ramp. He OJ'd it or overjumped it flat, and actually went on the rollout all the way up to the top and threw his bike down. Let's see what he puts together. He's rumored to have all kinds of good stuff.
Oh yeah, expect something big.
Cool. Body varial.
I was with this guy last week in Madrid, Spain. He's got the body varial. He actually has a pretty big 360 too, but was he lucky to get back on the bike there? I mean, it looked like he might have hung up on the way through.
I don't know if that was planned or not, but he grabbed the seat on the way back, and I think it made it look cooler.
Taking a look as he goes, spins around, he grabs a seat, so yes.
Oh yeah, variation.
He hung a little bit on that back fender.
Will the judges have seen that variation there? I think it's on the right side for the judges to see it, right?
Yeah, they
saw it. From the Mega Mo.
That was pretty awesome. Grabbed the bars, almost missed the grip, put his hand back on the grip. That's what best trick's all about, laying it down.
Going big.
Oh, I bet his toe hurts now. So the judges are on the side that he grabbed, so hopefully they saw it. Oh, yeah. Breaking the 90 barrier.
And the fans agree as the Australian breaks the 90 barrier, as Tess has pointed out. Speaking of breaking barriers, Robbie Madison, one of your buddies, Brian. This guy fears absolutely nothing. He is coming back from a crash on a very similar trick in the freestyle yesterday. Wow.
Another body burial. I'd say that one didn't have the seat grab super can in it, so I probably assume that'd be a little lower score, but he is riding with the hurt wrist.
He is riding with an injured wrist, but one thing I will point out, it was a lot cleaner.
It looked much smoother. I mean, he's much more upright in the rotation, and again, heartbreak for Robbie crashing yesterday. He's riding with an injured wrist, and he got a cortisone shot in that wrist so he could actually ride this thing. So you can imagine he's in significant pain. Look at this, Brian.
Really nose high, Brian. That's kind of scary sometimes.
When he let go of the bike, he gave it a good yank into him so it didn't get away from him, and it made him go nose high.
Interesting technique, though. If the nose high, that means the seat lower. Oh, yeah. They liked it. A little cleaner. And maybe they think that the seat grab was an accident from the rider before.
It could
be. From Clinton. You know?
A little squirrely.
The judges don't have the luxury of the replay. They get to see it as it happens in front of them. It's about 150 feet away from the judges' stand to the ramp. So they may have actually missed that grab, or it may have just looked a little scrappy.
Next up, Cam Sinclair.
Oh, wow.
From Australia. Now, this is Cam. He is coming to get that double backflip here at X Games, and it has bit him before, Tess.
Oh, it bit him big in Madrid, Spain last year. He crashed. He was in a coma for 7 days. Had to learn how to walk again.
This one's got my heart going. I hope he lands this. Oh! That's what's up. That is the ultimate comeback. comebacks. I thought he was never going to ride again. That's what it's all about.
It's got to be one of the greatest comebacks in sports.
Honestly, it almost brings a tear to my eye.
Oh, wow.
Unbelievable. Sinks, as they call him. Cam Sinclair. Double backflip. Gets a little off access test.
Oh, yeah. He looked like he was going sideways there, but pull it back and just stubbed the toe on the landing. But take a look at this again from the Megamo. You see the wheel turned on the takeoff.
When we get sideways like that, it's when you're trying to find the landing too early, and it put him a little bit sideways.
Great execution. A little bit of foot down, and there you go. Fellow Aussie, Robbie Madison.
Oh, wow. And just going back last year, I mean, it was such a hard time for everybody to go through in the sport. And remember, in a coma for 7 days, literally had to learn how to walk, how to feed himself, how to talk.
Is it enough?
It's gotta be.
By a long ways. That's awesome.
Now,
how cool.
Freestyle motocross, like any sport, is a family, and you hear a lot of cheering around, a lot of excitement. People are just excited with the comeback of Cam Sinclair. I mean, that is testimony to what he has been able to accomplish coming back from such a vicious crash.
Yeah, I mean, that's motivation for everyone.
Now,
wow,
Cam Sinclair throwing down an unbelievable score. Paris Rosen came here last year, missed on the front flip, but since that time, he has been able to put the front flip to dirt. However, he has not hit the jump here inside the stadium tonight.
Had a lot of problems with the bike. He was coming out for practice, and he had to turn around, go back. They said they were going to work on the carburetor in this bike. He is not feeling confident.
We'll see. He's rolling into the 75-foot jump.
Oh! Oh, my God.
Yeah. So, ladies and gentlemen, of course, freestyle motocross. Unbelievably tough sport. And we do have great medical crew on staff. Of course, the Asterisk Mobile medical crew is on board, as well as a great staff. Moto X best trick. So tough where these riders really push the limits. And Brian, I know that you've gone through some horrific crashes yourself. So tough to push so hard.
That's the toughest thing about freestyle and is the crashes. I just don't like seeing guys hit the ground that hard, and hopefully he's okay.
And you hear the crowd cheering for him. And again, ladies and gentlemen, great medical staff attending. Paris Rosen went for the front flip. It just didn't look like he got the pop off the ramp.
It really never looked like he was even close to that. And again, it, like we said, he's had a really rough day with that bike. It just hasn't been working. He didn't get the chance to hit the ramp, so he at least felt comfortable. A different run-in this year from last year. There's actually more space here on the floor this year at Staples Center. So all of that contributing, I'm sure, to, you know, making something that he's actually landed this thing. I mean, that's the whole, you know, the whole point here. He has landed the front flip before, but that was a tough one.
I think it's a little tougher coming in off that roll-in. It sets your suspension up a little different. It just didn't look like he got into the compression.
And, you know, the thing is, too, that all setups are always just a little bit different, Brian. And, I mean, whether it's the atmosphere in the room or how the bike is set up. I mean, there's always so many different variations that you have to deal with.
And one of the things I'll say about Paris, I mean, he is a tough guy. You can see he really he works out. He really, really puts the effort in. And there you see the that Honda rolling out there. And obviously, it took a pretty hefty whack itself.
It's the toughest thing about flip tricks. There's really no backing out. You have to commit. Otherwise, it's just... turns out really bad.
And this, the front flip is kind of like, I mean, I'm going to give an example you know all too well. You know, the 360 in the front flip, the margin for error is so slight because if you over-rotate or under-rotate, you know, it's almost certainly going to end in you coming off that bike.
For sure. Last under-rotation I had, I lost a kidney, and it's not an easy sport.
And again, ladies and gentlemen, we're waiting here, of course, optimistic. Paris Rosen being attended to by the medical staff here. And
you can see there, actually, Dr. Chow is right in with Paris now, just making sure. And the medical staff here, they train for every possible circumstance. They're ready for this. Everyone is very calm. They just go through... They go through a procedure that they understand, so you can see how calm everyone is. No panic there on the right of your screen in the white shirt. That is Dr. Chow, so they'll make sure that Paris is well taken care of. Now you see Kyle Loza wandering out, just taking a look.
And again, this is all community here. Everybody concerned for each other. And so tough. And the medical crew getting him off the floor here at Staples Center. And again, our prayers and thoughts with Paris. And just hope for the best. And let's check in as the crowd applauds Paris leaving. Again, just hoping for the best. Let's go down to Aaron Bates.
Well, guys, a tough deal for Cam Sinclair. His mom, Monica, his dad, Daniel, and his girlfriend, Tiffany, are here supporting him. Pardon me, Paris Rosen. He is finally responding, but they are taking him to the local hospital here. He was moving his right arm. That's basically the only update that we have at this moment, but he is in the best care possible.
Appreciate that update, Aaron. And just such a... You know, it's so tough, Brian, and I know we can't talk about enough how much effort goes into coming and learning new tricks. Yes, there's foam pits, but at the end of the day, there's no safety net. What happened here, Brian?
He didn't get the rotation off the ramp, bottom line, and he still went for it, so you got to give him credit for that. He didn't back out right off the ramp, and it's bad news right from the get-go.
And he started pushing. I mean, as soon as he left the ramp, you could see now he's still trying to make that bike rotate.
And Brian, as a freestyle motocross rider, I mean, there's times when you really know that it's going wrong and there's really nothing you can do. And at the end of round one, these... are our leaders, Cam Sinclair, the number one position, pulling off the double backflip. Robbie Madison with a 90.66 sitting in second. And Clinton Moore in third. Those are your top three.
And all Australian top three.
Oh, yeah.
How about that? Australia, I mean, they really are. They're the breakout country for freestyle motocross. They just keep shipping guys across here. And, well, it tells you there, Sinclair, Matto, Clinton. I guess they're claiming it now.
A little bit crazier over there on that side of the world.
Let me remind you that is the first runs of Freestyle Moto X Best Trick. We will see more in the second runs from all these riders. Everybody gets another shot. Your best score is the one that'll count.
You can fence in your yard, you can pull out the cars, but
And again, huge props to Monster Energy Drink for bringing this without commercials.
Moto X best trick.
And we will continue on. And of course, for the riders, Brian, so hard to go after seeing such a big crash. Again, you've been in those positions. Is it hard to collect yourself, especially since you're so up, and then there's a big break, and you've seen a rider go down like that?
It's one of the toughest things to witness is a big crash like that, and get your mindset back, amped up, ready to go, and positive, ready to stick that landing. So you just have to block it out.
And, of course, Ford is a part of the X Games here, and you can see this Militia Ford. Brian actually racing a Ford in Rally tomorrow, so getting together, the Ford people have the finalists in the Ford I Win, You Win promotion are here. And Nagresh Dugal has rider Taka Higashino as his pick, and Nicole Koop has Cam Sinclair as her pick, and Nicole looking very good right now with Cam Sinclair. So the Ford, I Win, You Win. And Ford going to be giving away a car here. That's pretty cool. And you practiced for Rally all day today, Brian. Tomorrow is the Rally competition. How incredible is that going to be?
Rally is awesome. The Fords are the fastest cars out there on the track. So tune in. You're going to see a Ford take the win. They're definitely giving away a Ford tonight. That's what it looks like.
All right, so 1 point behind Travis Pastrana in the freestyle competition was this silver medalist from New Zealand, Levi Sherwood.
And if anybody could bring the energy up in here, it's this guy. He has such youthful exuberance. He really just enjoys riding his bike. He said he's going to do safety tricks. I suspect we may see the big kiss of death that he does with his back arch. You can see the flip lever. See the black thing above his left hand? That is a flip lever so he can twist that bike around in the air and hang way off it. Levi Sherwood. Wow!
Pretty awesome.
Yeah, what do you think of the version of the trick that Levi brings, Brian?
Even if the trick is a little bit old, he does it better than anyone. The extension is scorpioned out. He really flicks that bike out there. And he's a youngster coming up. It's cool to see.
And we'll take another look at, of course, Todd Potter earning medals with that in 2007 and 2008. The kiss of death, look through flip. Excellent execution by Sherwood. Great extension. This guy is a huge talent in freestyle motocross.
Definitely an up-and-comer.
Oh,
look at that extension. Bigger than most guys do it right side up.
And look at how the bike stalled there. The bike is basically nose down, and it stops for a second in the air. That's just got to be terrifying.
That's good.
And he had an 84.33. Sinclair sitting in first with a 94.33. He will better his score, but it will put him in the fifth position.
Doesn't
and that
better
is
his
second,
place, yeah.
Second and final run. And Taka Higashino from Japan, right now sitting just outside the medals with an 89.66. He needs to better a 90.33 to get in to that bronze medal position.
I think so. I think he will. He'll go for a double grab, maybe Indian Air, add something to it.
And he was the first Japanese competitor here in Moto X in 2007. His buddy Ego Sato was supposed to be here tonight, but double grab Indy. You called it, Brian.
Hold it smooth.
And he's loving
that. Oh, yeah. And like we were saying, Ego Sato was supposed to be here. Great friend of Taka's, but unfortunately crashed last week. So he's sitting in a hospital in Japan. I'm sure he's watching us. But that was fantastic. Really, really good work in the legs.
Taka comes off the ramp. Really have to yank it to give it that stall to let your hands go. Great extension. Lands it smooth. He almost makes it look too easy, which could hurt his score.
And just another look at this. Watch him go back at one motion to the double grab and then scissor kicking the legs. Tess bettering his score. It has to
better his score, and I really hope the judges notice the movement of the hands because that's incredible. Yes! Wow!
Taka's been around for a while, and he's, as you guys have been saying, this is going to be a bust-out year for him. He looked good in freestyle, wasn't able to get to the round where he wanted,
but very solid there. What about this guy? You ride with him. I mean, I can't even imagine what the militia foam pit looks like with all these guys coming out to ride. And Potter, will he bring something new or will he go with something he knows?
We'll see. I think Potter, I haven't seen him in the pit much, so something gets off that cliffhanger. It's probably eating at him a little bit from last run.
Yep, and much better execution that time. Still not completely straight up and down, though, Tass.
Oh, way better. He did really poke the hands up or down, I guess it is in this case. So the judges are going to give him a better score for that one, but I just don't know if it's good enough to really move him up high on the table.
Taking another look. Nice extension there. And, you know, he has that kiss of death look through flip like Sherwood has, but he knows that that puts Sherwood in fifth, so Potter trying to stick, and actually pretty solid extension when you look at it with the replays.
I'd say it was a really good extension, but the trick is old, so breaking the top five, I don't know, maybe.
We'll see. He's sitting in sixth as of right now, and he does better his score.
Nope. Won't break him into the five, though.
Just didn't work this year.
And remember, we will have more Moto X on Sunday as we go with the speed and style. And here, one of the newcomers, Rich Kearns.
So Kearns had a little problem last time out. Remember, he hung up the boot there as he was going through the bars. He's trying for a big dead body variation.
Wow.
A little bit better. Dead body ending. He's fairly happy he landed that and rode away.
New to X Games, first time ever competitor. It was an alternate to freestyle. Did not compete there in freestyle, but he brought the game that he was trying to put down here, and a very solid execution. Something new, a little different. That's what this whole best trick event is all about. Wow. That's very solid look back.
That
too.
Is, and you know what? He is side on to the judges, so they'll see how much he was lying over the seat and kicking those legs out. So that could get him a pretty good score. We'll have to see if they reward something new.
And he is sitting in sixth position. He actually bumps Potter back, scoring an 88. And it's pretty darn cool, I gotta say, Tess, to be able to do this with no commercials. Thanks to Monster Energy Drink, just bringing us straight through the competition. I mean, that's how we do it.
Hey,
go.
You know what? It's really nice that the guys don't have to hang around and wait for anything. Everyone is just getting to go. They're feeling the flow. I mean, it's got to make life easier for you, Brian.
That helps out so much, especially when you're stressing about landing a trick, taking a break. Straight through. This is good. Can he step it up right now? Trying to land it a little smoother, it looks like. He's trying to go for that perfection to knock out Madison.
Yeah, he's trying to look smoother. I just hope the judges realize he's trying to grab the bike instead of just trying to bring himself back on the bike with that right hand. It's easy for us to see in this one that he's going around and he actually places that right hand. Look, he's going for the hole underneath the seat there, Brian.
He did it actually. Perfect. He came around, grabbed the seat. It's almost like a super can. Landed the bike good. Didn't jerk it out and wheelie the bike. Bike stayed pretty level.
I think he was, you know, possibly he's looking for a seat grab variation at the end of it.
Could have been going for a little Indy air at the end.
Yeah, maybe just didn't think he had enough time there.
If you watch he and Madison, they have different styles because he's hanging on that left side of the bike and then coming over with the seat grab.
He's just outside the medals and he's going to stay there. A great welcome to the X Games for him. And hey, I think I just got the best news of the X Games. You want it? Do you want to hear it?
Oh, we want to hear it.
Lay it on.
Paris Rosen is in X Games Medical. He is awake, alert, and moving all extremities.
That's fantastic.
This is incredible news. If you're at home, you can give a round of applause for Paris Rosen. Going for it completely.
Amazing. Tough guy.
You saw Robbie Madison there visualizing. He was spinning around with his eyes closed there.
What's he got?
Can he do it better is the question.
He's sitting in second position right now.
He was talking about a heel clicker at the end of it, so maybe he can add something to it.
Oh, yes, Maddo.
There it is. That's what it's about. Stepping it up.
And the Staples crowd going wild. He had heartbreak yesterday. He crashed with that trick. He hurt his wrist. And he wasn't able to challenge Travis Pastrana. Some people say he could have beaten Pastrana in freestyle for the gold.
Let's take another look at it. Taking the trick to another level, Tess.
Here we go. He knows he's got it. Crosses over again and side saddles it.
Now, Brian, you used a side saddle lander to take the X Games gold at Winter X Game one time before.
And you have to have the bike pretty straight to land side saddle. I'd say he had it just about kicked out just about right.
And of course, landing, as you pointed out, in the freestyle comp where riders were doing it, landing with no foot on the brake side of the bike, so losing a lot of control availability on the motorcycle.
And he went for, even though that bike was a little bit sideways, and he could have had a big, big problem on the landing. Will it be enough to beat Sinclair for gold? Let's see.
No.
No.
It does get him out of the tie with Taka. Matto to second place. And I'm here to say, I think Matto would be just as stoked with Sinclair getting the gold medal.
I guarantee you. Well, there is Sinclair's fiance, Brooke. She has had the toughest year you can possibly imagine. You see all the Aussie flags. Brooke has stood by Cam's side. Every time he goes out to ride, she has to sit and watch this happen. And I guarantee you, she is so happy right now.
Brian.
Awesome, man.
This is one of your guys. How crazy and exciting is that for him as we take a look? Nicole Coop has just won.
She won
a
your
Ford car.
Car.
There we go. Militia'd up. But how is this for Cam Sinclair?
Above all, this is the ultimate comeback story. Above all, if everyone really just researched what he came back from, that was the ultimate comeback.
The Aussie flag wrapped around his shoulders. Let's go down to Aaron with our winner.
Talk about the ultimate comeback. The rookie comes in not since 2006, and Travis Pastrana pulled off the double backflip. Has it ever been landed here at X? What was the thought and feeling going through your mind?
Well, you know, I've been doing it for like 2 years now, and everything's been going well except for, you know, last year in Spain. I had that bad accident, and I didn't think I was ever going to be able to come back and do that trick again. But, you know, I just put a lot of hard work into it, and, you know, I knew I could do it. It's just amazing. It's been a lifetime dream to win a gold medal.
Take us through that horrific crash. From that, you come back, you made the comeback. How much sweeter is this gold medal?
Oh, it's amazing. You know, it's like 100% better than what it actually would be if I didn't have that crash. And it was, you know, 6 months ago, I was just started riding again, and I've come a long way since then, you know, I had another trick saved, you know, just in case I wasn't leading going into that last run, but at least I got something for next year now.
Congratulations, all your hard work and dedication paid off. The gold medalist, Cam Sinclair.
I'm just here to say that I like his name, Cameron Sinclair. But hey, gold medal. Let's take another look at it, Brian. Great execution, little off access.
Just a little bit tweaked out, but he stepped it up, took the biggest chances tonight. He got rewarded. The right man won the competition.
And I've got to say, from that horrible night in Madrid to here, this is the triumph of triumphs. Great comeback for Sinclair.
Cam Sinclair with the gold medal, and thank you mucho to Monster Energy for bringing it to us commercial free. Monster Energy drink, doing it, letting the athletes go out and flow. And Cam Sinclair bringing home the gold. Robbie Madison will be your silver medalist, and Taka Higashino will be bringing home the bronze medal. What a great show, but let us not forget skateboarding best trick coming up in just a little bit. One more time, people, stand up and applaud. This is Cam Sinclair bringing home the bacon, so to speak, and he'll be taking the gold all the way home to Australia.